I am Santosh Gaidankar. Today I am teaching you SFD and BMD diagram of this problem. That is shear force diagram and the bending moment diagram. It's a cantilever problem. One end is fixed and here UL is there provided. This is nothing but UVL, uniform varying load. Point load is acting here with a couple. Now I will going to make the assumptions here. Now the downward arrow, downward force, I will consider as a positive. Upward, I will consider as a negative. For the couple, anticlockwise, I will consider as a positive. For clockwise, I will consider as a negative. This is for couple. This is for couple. This is for load. Intensities, downward positive, upward negative. For bending moment, I'm considering this is hogging as negative and sagging positive. This is for the shear force you can consider. Now, first I'm going to convert everything into a point load. Here, downward arrow. This is A, B. 30 kilonewton intensity is there, a couple 100 kilonewton meter. Now here it is C and D, and we are making this one into a point load. If you measure UVL from this end, we have to consider from the base, we have to consider 1 by 3 into base. This is the base, or this is nothing but from the bottom. You can say this is the bottom. You have to consider 1 by 3 into base. Or if you are measuring from this side, you have to consider 2 by 3 into base in order to convert into point load. Now I am converting into a point load here. Point load from this side I will consider as a 1 by 3 into base. What is base here? 2. If you want to calculate from this end, you have to take 2 by 3 into base. That is 2 by 3 into 2. You will get this value. Now indicate the length. From here to here it is 2 meter, from here to here it is 1 meter, now from here to here it is 0.67 and here it will be 1.33. 0.67, just deduct with 2 minus 0.67, you will get 1.33, or 2 by 3 into 2, you will get 1.33. Now just draw the lines for the construction of shear force and bending moment diagram. Now shear force, now this point at the D, there is no load here, therefore you can write SF at D will be 0. Now at C, SF at C, there is a load here which is 2. If it is bottom, we are considering as a positive. It is not 2, it is, sorry, we have to write here 1 by 2 into base into this height 20, which is nothing but 20 kilonewton. This is nothing but 20 kilonewton. Okay. Now here plus 20 kilonewton at C. The shear force at C is 20 kilonewton. Now here shear force at B. Here you have to consider left and right because the load is acting at the B here. When there is no load, directly you can write a single digit. If the load acts, you have to take left and right. Now first I will consider the right, then it will be 20 kilonewton. Now I am considering the left, this side, SF at B left, which includes 20 kilonewton, 20 plus 30, which is nothing but 50 kilonewton. While doing the shear force, we have to avoid the couple, and couple has to be calculated when we are going to calculate bending moment. Now at A there is no load, SF at A there is no load acts here, therefore a single digit, which is nothing but 50 kilonewton. Now we are drawing the shear force diagram based on this part. This is shear force diagram. We are drawing upward is considered as a positive and bottom is considered as a negative. The first is 50 kilonewton. Next, B for the left it is 50. That means on B, on a single line of B, there will be 50 and 20. First, we are considering a 50 here. 50. Next, exactly on the same line, it is 20, it is bottom, 20 kilonewton. Next, at C, again it will be 20, C, this is the C line, it is 20 kilonewton. At D, it is 0. Now join. Straight line, because there is no load here. Again there is a straight line because there is no load here. Now it is a UVL which is decreasing. It is decreasing, therefore you have to draw parabolic curve. This is parabolic curve. If it is increasing, then you have to draw in this way. It is decreasing now, therefore a parabolic curve in this way you have to draw. This completes your shear force diagram. Now we are going for bending moment. Bending moment diagram. Now first I will consider the bending moment at A. The bending moment at A. First, this is the first force, 20. Now it is acting downward, that it means hogging, or you can consider a sad face is considered as a negative or smiling face is considered as a positive. Now as the load is applied, which is nothing but it is going to bend in this way, that means it is a sad face, we have to consider negative. The first here, this is the first load acts here, minus 20 into distance. Distance will be 0.67 plus 1 plus 2. Now there is a couple here, couple has to be considered during bending moment and couple has to be avoided in shear force. Now there is a couple. I have considered the couple. If the couple is in this way, anti-clockwise, I am considering as a positive. Plus 100. Plus 100. Again there is a load, minus 30 into distance 2. If you calculate, the value will be minus 33.4 kilonewton meter. Similarly, at B, bending moment at B. But at B, there is a couple here. As the couple appears, you have to consider right and left. You have to consider right and left. Bending moment at B, now left. Now this point, I am considering the left is nothing but this point. This is the left hand, I am considering the left side. Left side. Now, first will be minus 20. Minus 20 into 0.67 plus 1, and there is a couple here, left side, the couple is visible, then plus 100, plus 100. If you calculate, the value will be 66.6 kilonewton meter. Next, on right side, BMB on right. Whenever there is a couple appears, you have to take left and right. Now, as on right, minus 20 into distance into 0.67 plus 1. The value will be 13.4 kilonewton meter. Minus 13.4 kilonewton meter. Now we got left and right of the couple here. Next, at the point C, BMB at C is nothing but minus 20 into 0.67, which is nothing but, sorry, this value will be 33.4 kilonewton and this value will be minus 13.4 kilonewton meter. This will be minus 33.4 kilonewton, and the bending moment at D will be 0. Now we have to draw the bending moment. Bending moment. BMD. The first value is for A is minus 33. The first value will be minus 33.4 kilonewton meter at A. This is the A point. And next, left, that is 66, positive, 66.6 kilonewton meter, because on the same line of B, you will get two values, 66.6 kilonewton positive and one more 33.4 negative, minus 33.4 kilonewton negative on the same line. Next, at C, it is 13.4 kilonewton meter, and D will be 0 here. Now, from this point to 66, straight line, or we call it as an inclined line. Next, join this line. Again, this line. If there is a UDL, then you have to draw a curve, a parabolic curve you have to draw. Now here, it is a UVL, therefore we are going to draw a cubic. Now there is a crossing of positive and negative side in the bending moment diagram. See here, it is negative to positive, there is a crossing. Then we have to find out a point of contraflexure. How to find out the point of contraflexure? Consider this distance as x and this distance will be 2 minus x. Irrespective of the sign, write in this way, x divided by this value 33.4 is equal to 2 minus x divided by 66.6. Don't consider the negative sign, irrespective of negative sign. You have to consider only the positive sign here in order to get the x value. Now with the help of calculator, alpha x divided by 33.4 shift, sorry, alpha sol bracket open 2 minus alpha x divided by 66.6 shift sol is equal to, the x value will be 0.668 meter. 0.668 meter, and this is nothing but point of contraflexure. Point of contraflexure. This is nothing but point of contraflexure. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.